Wow, that was a lot of feedback.
That was a lot of feedback, but very good constructive feedback.
Yes, good constructive feedback.
We found some issues that we knew about. Mm-hmm. We found some issues that we didn't know about. You know, one thing that strikes me here, though, is that maybe we went a little overboard on producing high-fidelity mocks.
Yeah, we definitely did, because we're going to need to change a lot of these things.
Yeah, I
think
so.
And, you know, man, I spent so long getting this little plus, this little check marks to work right. I spent so long getting these fabs up. Wasted hours.
Yeah, you know, I think that, you know, we probably could have dialed it back just a little bit. We probably could have gone with some wireframes to suss out some of the details that we were looking at. Mm-hmm. You know, and particularly when we talked to Hugh and we talked to Parima, we talked a little bit about fab placement, things like that. You know, perhaps we could have done that with a wireframe.
Yeah, I think we could have, and I think that would have saved us a lot of time because we could have gotten this feedback faster and then not had to lose as much work as we're going to.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, one of the things we were sweating as we were talking about some of these mocks too is like the color and position of some of these things. And I think that that was largely irrelevant to the feedback that we got.
Yeah.
So I think that maybe some of those discussions could have waited until later in the cycle.
They could have. Some of those things though, some of the design issues are things that came up. Like we had the checkbox, you know, we asked people to check off these apps and Pornima was able to find the little checkbox here very quickly, but Hugh just could not find that there was something in this app for to-do lists.
Yeah, that's right. You know, I did find it interesting, too, that we got contradictory feedback in that regard from both participants. You know, they wanted to look at the home screen. You know, Hugh felt strongly that he wanted to see past events or completed events, mm-hmm. whereas Parima didn't feel that she wanted to see them. She really wanted to see that be as clean and clear as possible.
Right.
You know, so I think we probably should start annotating some of this stuff.
We should.
You know, I think that one of the things we're going to have to do is probably dig into this screen a little bit, and we're probably going to have to add some a stronger affordance for completion, task completion.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's clear that even if we had intended for the tasks to be swipeable here, that's not intuitive.
Let's get you some post-its notes, too, because I think we're going to take a lot of notes here, because we're really going to have to focus on the next iteration here. Mm-hmm. We really need to settle in on a specific interaction. So that we can make sure that the next round of testing, we get a really cohesive flow and that our users really understand that clearly.
Right.
So task completion was one thing. The other thing we talked about was whether or not we need actually a strong affordance here for completing tasks.
Right.
Now, this is a heads-up display screen, though.
Mm-hmm. So it is a heads-up display screen. We'd intended it to be sleek and not have all of these extra things on it.
Yeah, it's an at-a-glance type thing.
But if we also, you know, We had decided originally that this was going to be sort of equally a calendar app and a to-do app, and so both of those things should be doable from the home screen, from whatever screen we land people on.
Well, you know, actually, Hugh had some interesting feedback there, though. He was confused as whether or not this is a calendaring app or a to-do app.
Right.
You know, we initially set out with the intent of doing kind of, I think, a mashup of both.
Yeah.
But he was really confused because there didn't seem to be any task management here. There was no what are we doing. There's
That's
a lot of who, what, and where, but not, I'm sorry, who, where, when, but not what.
Yeah.
We're really missing that what aspect.
We are, and that's a thing that we just completely missed in the design process. You know, we have options then, you know, to address that. We can either say, okay, we need to re-emphasize that. We need to have these big, big check boxes here.
Maybe, yeah, absolutely.
Maybe even actually this shape here just pasted in as the way of doing it, because our icon is a checkbox. That is a thing that we clearly have in the design up here, but it's not a thing that we have in the design down here. Or we could do something like, you know, change this icon, make it just a calendaring app. And that's, you know, it's addressing a different problem, but it's one that we've already addressed pretty well.
Well, you know, but the thing that we really wanted to go after here was that strong marriage between between to-do and calendar.
Mm-hmm.
And so I feel like if we abandon the to-do aspects of the app, then maybe we're not holding true to the true promise of what we intended to set out to do.
Right.
I do like your suggestion of reusing the app icon a little bit more. Hugh gave us some interesting feedback that he felt the affordance here for the checkbox needed to be stronger.
Mm-hmm.
He missed it when he first looked at it. Pranima also had some issues with it. You know, we were talking about these gray circles not being a strong enough affordance for a checkbox, I'm sorry. So I think that we need to really strengthen this stuff.
Right, and we can strengthen that by making it larger. We can strengthen that by, you know, making it square, because, you know, again, I expect radio buttons to be round and checkboxes to be square usually.
Yeah, you know, one of the things that just came to mind is that perhaps we can take just this one screen and do a couple of iterations on that one screen and give those to some users for some very directed feedback.
Right.
On those specific elements.
Mm-hmm.
Do they feel good about using this checkbox as that affordance?
Right.
Will they pick up on the fact that it is a way of completing the task?
Right, so you're saying we can do user testing on just iterations of a specific screen rather than the entire flow.
That's right, yeah. We can actually drill down on specific features too.
Mm-hmm.
One of the pieces of feedback that we got was actually talking about gesture-based support.
Right, because we had one person who said that the swiping should be more options, and we had
right.
one person who said that the swiping should be, you know, delete, complete.
That's right, or complete. So, you know, I certainly think that we should probably strive to keep our UI here very simple. So I don't know that Pranima's suggestions of revealing a panel behind these screens is really gonna be the direction that we wanna go in, but I definitely think gesture-based support is something that we need to investigate with a higher fidelity prototype.
Right, and when I'm thinking about that, you know, gesture-based support, we can rely either on what we expect users to have already seen in other apps, or we can have an instructional thing. You know, we have this mock over here that's, we have a place that we can have information that's just sort of an overlay on this screen.
Yeah.
We could have that inform users about how to swipe and how to complete a task if we wanted to.
I think that's something that we're gonna have to test a little bit more too, because anecdotal evidence suggests too that some of these splash screens, it prevents people from actually engaging in the app. Sometimes they want a little bit more serendipitous discovery.
Right.
Pranima, for instance, was very willing and very tolerant of just playing with an app to see
right.
how it worked.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas I think Hugh was a little bit more regimented in his needs.
Yeah.
So
Hugh wanted it to be, you know, if it's a to-do list app, we should be able to check things off quickly.
That's right, that's right. What was some of the other feedback that we got?
Well, you know, first off, we got some positive feedback, right?
That
when we asked people to make a new event, both of the testers, they went straight to these fabs. Especially, you know, on these two screens, they just went straight for that fab. That's exactly what we hoped for, and the affordances were clearly big enough for those,
even though
they're smaller than this affordance.
Yeah, you know, the one question that did come up is maybe this affordance is just a little bit too big.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because it might cover up, you know, I can't see whether it's just the one person going to this event or multiple, because one of them might be under the fab.
Yeah, that's right. So we might actually be having a little bit of an issue with hiding some of the data there. But I agree that positive feedback is really encouraging that at least the users are able to pick up where the fab is and what it does. They all clearly understood that was event creation.
Yeah, we also got feedback that was sort of something that we weren't looking for originally, which is both of our testers, we had them expect to be able to click on this and open a screen like this, but that shows current details. And we actually didn't mock that up.
That's true, we did not. You know, one of the other things that just caught my eye in our design here is that, and perhaps something that led to Hugh's confusion, if you look here, we call this thing a task. If you look here, we call it a task. But if you look here in this screen, we call it an event.
That's true, actually. That is a thing that I hadn't thought about, because, you know, as we were designing this, we were thinking of those as sort of the same object.
That's right.
You know, we were thinking this is a task slash event. And I guess we don't communicate anymore that that's a thing that we expect. We sort of had an expert blind spot there.
Yep, that definitely happened. Well, we're gonna have to rectify that.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe involving a tech writer in this project would be a good idea if we have access to one.
Right.
That might cost us a little bit of money, so maybe we should just keep an eye for consistency.
So as another option, we might be able to, you know, present the same flow with maybe all of these say event, or all of these say task, or some
that's
other
right.
word that might communicate all of that, and just see, you know, is Hugh able to figure that out? Is Pranima able to figure that out? Is anyone else that we have in our office able to figure that out?
Yeah, I think that's a great suggestion. Not only testing some of the UI components, like for instance where the fab was or whether or not there's a hero element, but testing the language of the app is a really important part of, I think, bringing the highest fidelity to our experience.
Mm-hmm.
We really want that measure of consistency through our app for our users.
Right. All right. So, wow, we've got a lot of feedback and we've got a lot of things that we can iterate on.
Yeah.
I think right now it's time to take a quick look at this feedback and think about what is actionable.